Children, these minerals, they are obtained from mines, and they are obtained by the process of mining. These minerals, we have seen that some are found in free state, whereas some are found in ore form. These ores are nothing but the impure forms, those are obtained in soil, sand. And these ores, they contain the soil and sand, and that part is called gangue. Now, these minerals, they can be identified. They have some properties, and based on those properties, these minerals are classified into some types. Which are those properties? Those properties are their color, their luster, hardness, cleavage or fracture, the streaks. These are their properties that differentiate them differently. For example, if gold is there, it has different luster, shining appearance, whereas the hardness can be seen in diamond. Diamond is the hardest mineral. And in this way, all these are differentiated based on their properties. Now, we are going to study the classification of minerals according to their properties. There are three classes of those minerals: non-metal minerals, metal minerals, and energy minerals. Now, the examples of non-metal minerals are mica, sulfur, gypsum, potash, graphite and diamond. These are not metals. These are non-metal minerals. Whereas metal minerals, we know the properties of metals. They are having hardness, then density, they can be made into thin sheets. That means they have malleability. They can be made into wires. That means they have ductility. All these things, they differentiate them from non-metals. And iron, gold, silver, tin, bauxite, manganese, platinum, tungsten, these are the metal minerals. Whereas energy minerals include coal, mineral oil, natural gas, etc. See, these are three classes of minerals: non-metal minerals, metal minerals and energy minerals. From these energy minerals we get energy. These are the sources of energy: coal, then mineral oil, natural gas. That's why they are called energy minerals. Now, we have studied all these things about these minerals. Now we will study some important minerals as well as their ores and their uses also. Iron ore. Iron ore is the impure form of iron, and it contains high proportion of iron. This iron ore, it occurs in four main forms of ores. Which are these four main ores? Magnetite, hematite, limonite and siderite. Magnetite, hematite, limonite and siderite, these are the iron ores. And this iron, it is used to make heavy machines, heavy articles, as well as small pin. From small pin to heavy machinery articles, this can be made by these iron ores. Then farming implements or tools, they can also be made by this iron. Rails of railway tracks are made from iron. Due to its properties, it is used to make all these things. Then manganese. Manganese, it occurs in its different forms. Which are these forms? It occurs in carbonate form, silicate form and oxide form. Now, due to its properties, it is used in medicines. It is used to give pink tinge to glass. Also, it is used in electrical appliances. Now, bauxite. Bauxite is the very important, the most important ore of aluminium. See, this is the main ore of aluminium, and it occurs in the form of aluminium oxide. As it has low density and it has the good conductivity of electricity as well as heat. See, aluminium is good conductor of heat as well as electricity, and because of low density, it is used in aeroplanes, it is used in transport vehicles, and it is used to make electrical wires. Then copper. Copper, it also occurs in impure form in vicinity of iron and aluminium, and it is also very good conductor of heat as well as electricity, and it is ductile, it is malleable, it is having luster, it has all these properties, and it is used to make electric wires because of electrical conductivity. It is used in radio, telephones, as well as it can be used to make statues, idols, and kitchen utensils because of the conductivity of heat. Now, mica. Mica, it is a non-metal mineral, and it is used in Ayurvedic medicines, dyes, electric machines, wireless communication, etc. In this way, we have studied the some important minerals as well as their ores. And this bauxite is the most important ore of aluminium, and it contains near about 55% of aluminium. See, iron ore, manganese, bauxite, copper, and mica. All these are important ores. We have also studied their uses. Thank you.